Today on BRS TV, we have a quick product spotlight on the Red Sea Coloration Trace Element Program. This program fulfills all of my biggest desires for any product. It's very specific about its claims, transparent about what's in the product and how it works, and it uses a dosing methodology based on something that makes sense as well as knowing when you're dosing too much. All these things make it much easier to trust the manufacturer and evaluate the product's performance. The line comes with four different additives. Coral Colors A, which is iodine and halogens, includes iodine, bromine, and fluorine, which will promote the production of pink coloration through the increased production of pink chromoproteins, which are related to iodine and bromine. The halogens also act as antioxidants and oxidative agents within the coral's soft tissue, which helps the coral rid itself of free oxygen radicals produced by the zooxanthellae and prevents bleaching. Coral Colors B will bring out the reds in your corals by dosing boron and potassium, which is related to the red chromoproteins. Potassium also helps the coral transport nutrients within its soft tissue, as well as form the proper aragonite skeletal structure. Coral Color C will bring out the green coloration primarily with iron, but also contains trace amounts of other light metals like cobalt, manganese, aluminum, zinc, chrome, nickel, and even trace amounts of copper. Many of these elements are related to the production of green and yellow chromoproteins. Beyond color, these microelements in the C bottle help regulate and promote metabolic processes such as respiration, energy production, and photosynthetic catalysts. Coral Colors D will help promote the purple and blue colors in your corals with 18 trace elements, including silver, gold, vanadium, and tungsten, which promote the production of the blue and purple chromoproteins. There are two ways to dose these products. One's based off of testing the levels and figuring out a weekly or daily dose, and another which is based off of the amount of calcium used. Each one will be attractive to different people. Red Sea has found that most corals utilize most trace elements in a ratio that's closely tied to calcium consumption, which frankly makes a lot of sense. What's nice about this is there are tons of accurate test kits for calcium, and the test kits are really easy to do. The same thing cannot be said of trace element test kits. There are only a handful of trace elements we can even test for at home, fewer accurate kits, and even fewer that are easy to perform or read. I will say that Red Sea produces the best kits that I have used. So matching the trace element dose to calcium dose is a really great solution for many reefers. This is as easy as dosing 1 milliliter of each trace element for every 10 milliliters of Red Sea two-part calcium solution dosed. There are a lot of different two-parts out there, and many of you are using a different brand, so it's a pretty common question if this line can be used in conjunction with those other brands. It absolutely can, and while I'm sure they would prefer to use their products exclusively, they'll still be pretty happy if you're using their trace elements as well as their related test kits. All you need to do is some math. They state that you need 1 milliliter of each trace element solution for every 20 parts per million of calcium dosed. Since many of you are using the BRS 2-part, we did the math for you. For every 51 milliliters of the BRS 2-part solution, you'll need to dose 1 milliliter of each trace element solution. These can be dosed daily, every few days, or even weekly. As an example, a tank like this one using BRS 2-part might require 100 milliliters a day of 2-part, which would mean 2 milliliters a day of each trace element solution, 6 milliliters every 3 days, or 14 milliliters once a week. Since none of these need to be refrigerated, you can absolutely hook these elements up to a dosing pump, just like your 2-part. We don't recommend you use Red Sea's color program in conjunction with a brand that states it already includes trace elements, because you would be doubling down on some elements and you run the risk of overdosing your tank. Now's probably a good time to note why Red Sea doesn't simply mix these elements in with their 2-part mix. Presumably it's because many of these elements cannot be mixed with calcium chloride or sodium carbonate without precipitating or causing other issues. 2-parts which have the trace elements mixed in are convenient, but they're limited as to what elements they can add. Keeping them separate really does open up the possibilities. Lastly, you can absolutely use this system with other calcium solutions like Kalkwasser and calcium reactors. It's just a bit more difficult to identify how much calcium your tank's consuming with these two methods. Calcium reactors are also likely adding some amount of trace elements as well, so we strongly recommend testing frequently when you start this program. If you're using this program or you have a question, check out the comments area down below. If this is your first time with us, we do this every week, so hit that subscribe button. We'll see you all next week with another episode of BRS TV.